Hello folks, welcome to the first segment of the K-drama couple analysis. I'm kidding, no, I'm stopped. Hey guys, this is my voice reveal, I guess. And first of all, thank you so much for watching all my videos. Yeah, I'm the same girl who uses Yobo a lot in her law school videos. Yeah, that's me. First of all, today I have decided to do this because it's something really new and it's been on my mind for a while now. I just feel like there are so many K-drama couples that, you know, we have to just like sit together and vibe to that and just like talk it out. So since we can't do that in person thanks to COVID, and also because no, that would be dangerous, we are doing this in a digital way. So I have decided to start with our beloved Solhi Nation. So if you have watched law school, you know that Junhee, our boy Junhee, has always been very helplessly in love with Kangsol A. Kangsol A never really liked him. Like for the first 15 episodes, she was like, no, my friend likes you, I can't like you back, you know, I can't like you even if you like me. And she's just like, you know, I always see you as a friend. But in episode 16, our boy Junhee finally had the chance, and finally Kangsol A likes him back too, because look at the change of our heart. I'm very proud, all of us are very proud of Junhee and very happy for him finally that the girl he likes now likes him back. Let's just like don't call Sol A as Sol A, let's just call her as Kangsol, because we clearly know which Sol we are talking about today, right? So today I'm going to talk about their evolution as like characters, with like their different personalities and how and what brings them together. So since the very beginning of the episode, the one thing that I've noticed is that Kangsol is very, very insecure about certain things. Like she definitely feels small amongst all the kids who are very smart, you know, and she goes to Hanguk Law School, which is like the best law school in Korea. So she definitely feels insecure that she's not good enough, and I would have felt that too, because she has smarties all around her. Even in her house, Byul is very smart, even Kangdan is very smart, and in her school there's Junhee anyway, and there's Sol B anyway. So she definitely feels that she is small amongst all of them, because all of them do better than her, you know. And that's one thing that has never been forced in the show, but has definitely been explored in the show. That's one thing that I really like about the show. And then you get to see this one thing that I had never noticed before, but since I edit their videos so many times, I just cannot help but notice the fact that Junhee and Kangsol have always been there for each other. Like, what I love most about their relationship is that they trust each other a lot. Because I feel like from Junhee, it could be because he always liked her, it could be because of that, but from Kangsol's side, it is such a natural thing for her to do. Like, she has always believed in Junhee. I remember in a few episodes, I guess around 4 or 5, wait, around I think 2 or 3 episodes, somewhere around that, everybody starts suspecting Junhee that he might be the killer. Kangsol was the only person who believed in him. She has always been like, Junhee can't do that. Does that even make sense? Do you guys even believe it? And she has always looked out for him in so many ways. And it has never been forced in the show, but like if you go back and watch the entire show, you'll see it. Like, it's all over there. So that's one thing that I've noticed, which I think is really sweet, you know. And then by the end of the show, we get to see how that has evolved and completely changed. And throughout the show, one thing that I've noticed, that Junhee and Kangsol are very different people. You know, they are morally very similar, but their personalities are very different. Like, their behaviors are very different. Like, Kangsol is like completely this outgoing, this lovable character that you just cannot hate. And Junhee has so many secrets, you know, he's not that talkative. But he becomes a completely different person with Kangsol, which is something that we will definitely explore in the segment later, you know, wait for it. But yeah, the difference, now that we're talking about Junhee's personality, let's talk about the difference, his personality difference. He's such a different person with Kangsol, which astonishes me to another level. So yeah, but now we're talking about Sol, right? We're talking about Kangsol. So Sol's character evolves very beautifully. I feel like her insecurities start to, you know, kind of, it starts to reduce as we go through that. And now when I think about it, I kind of do know why Professor Young gave her so many assignments, that you should do that, you should do that. And, you know, even between her exams, he gave her so many things. I think it was for her to explore her potential, because she always felt like she was surrounded by smarties and she was not good enough. So I always felt like that was the only thing that had been stopping her from exploring her own potential. So I think Joonhee also notices that. And I think that's the reason why he doesn't confess his feelings to her, because she has always had that tendency of feeling so, you know, small amongst all the smart kids. So maybe he didn't want to pressure that. And somebody wrote this on the comment section in one of my recent videos, and I do agree. Like, I cannot stop thinking about it. I think what that person said is completely true, because just imagine Joonhee confessing his feelings and Sola would be like, what is this pressure that's coming on to me? You know, we are on a different level. That's what she thinks, because she has always thought of that, thought of it like that. But then over the course of all the episodes and all the hours, we get to see that Joonhee also, you know, trusts her with her work. And then in episode 16, when he says that your work is good, you know, I think it's good, I don't have to play the prosecutor anymore, her smile, my goodness. And now that we're talking about this scene, can we talk about the sexual tension between them? Like, he's always looking at her, and this time she also looks back. His heart is definitely doing a cartwheel, folks. His heart is definitely flip-flopping on the floor. I was so happy to watch that episode. I feel like there's this hand scene, you know, where they do this. I don't know what it's called, because English is not my first language. I have no idea what it's called. But like, they do this handshake where they do it, and Sol B puts it first, and she kind of looks disappointed, you know. Uri Kang Sol looks a bit disappointed, and our husband is completely fine, because he knows how he feels about her, and still shamelessly looks at Kang Sol, despite knowing the fact that Sol B likes him a lot. And you know, I think that was all to make Sol realize her true feelings for him, because the way she says that I'll be rooting in your uncle's place, that is like the most nicest thing one could ever say to anybody. That is like the most purest thing. They're such cuties. I just feel like that is so nicely explored, and I think that Sol and our Joonhee, our Yobo, as a lot of you like to put it, they get together by the end, because when Professor Young calls them, both of them come together despite working in different locations, which doesn't necessarily mean that they're together, but it definitely means that they are still close. And when Joonhee looks at her like that, like he did in all the episodes since the beginning, it means that he doesn't like somebody else, or he's not seeing somebody else, because if he was seeing someone else, he wouldn't have looked at her like that, you know. He must have moved on, and that's why he was seeing someone else. So it definitely means that he's still into her. And the fact that she still looks back at him, and that's a meaningful look, right? There's a meaningful, it's very meaningful, it's deep. So it means, I think in my opinion, it means that they get together, because by the end of episode 16, like not even the end, it's like in episode 16, Sol is completely, like, she starts to develop feelings for him, and it's very obvious. Like, she's just like Joonhee when it comes to expressing feelings. So she keeps on looking at him, and there's this, I'll be rooting instead of your uncle's place, that is there. And then, even after a year, this time Joonhee does not follow her around. This time it's Kang Sol who follows him around, because when she sees Joonhee crossing and she calls him, and he still smiles the way he actually usually smiles when he's with her. And I think that is like the sweetest thing, because like the Kang Sol before episode 15 wouldn't have followed him like that, wouldn't have been waiting for him or even looked at him like that. But the Kang Sol in episode 16 and afterwards is, you know, developing her feelings, so that's why she follows him. And this time she's the one who's following him around, and I think that's the biggest progress in the show, because the fact that she likes him also, which means obviously over the years they probably get together, but it's not explored, and a lot of people are mad about it, and I kind of do understand, because you know, a lot of people take it very seriously. So I do understand that situation, but I also understand that it's not a romance themed drama. There's no romance there. The fact that we got Junhee and Kang Soo's relationship at the first place is something that we should be thankful about, because I never knew I needed them. I really never knew I needed them. Now I cannot even go to bed without thinking about them. That's how obsessed I have become when the casting was revealed. But I was like, and the actress, they won't look well together. But then they shattered my hopes, folks. They shattered it. They tore it apart. Like, they have the best chemistry. They have done it so well, and they have done it so smoothly. So yeah, that's it for today's rant video. I'll be making a lot more of that. So if you do have some suggestions of the next drama couple you want me to talk about, I'll do it. Or the next drama that you want me to talk about, or anything that you want me to talk about, I'll do it. I'll do everything for you all. I'm so grateful for you all. And I have said it so many times, I'll say it again. I never wanted to make another video because nobody would comment on my videos, and I used to be so sad because I was like, nobody comments on my video, you know, they don't like it, they don't like my editing, they hate it. But then I loved Junhee, I love Soulhee so much, I decided to make the one last video of my life, and then you guys watched it and you guys loved it, and I'm so grateful for that. And that's why I have decided to not give up and to believe in myself and to believe in you guys, and I'm so grateful for you, and I'm so thankful that you guys watch me. It's like the biggest, it's like my dream come true. I'm already blushing right now like an idiot. So yeah, that's it for today's video. Thank you so much. Do watch it. Do let me know what is the next thing you want me to do. I'll do it. I'll do everything. Your wish is my command. So okay, bye bye.